class 4 in your e-learning EBS classes, and as we are started already year to year, this is the second chapter which we are revising. So if somehow you have left that video which I have actually given you for your study, so you can go through your revision chapters and you will get the same material from the revision things. And there, I will discuss all the questions over here. And I am very sorry, due to some error in the e-portal, I was unable to upload some homework. So I think soonly it will be become okay, or it will become cured. So that time, maybe today or maybe tomorrow, I will upload your homework in the e-portal site. Okay, so go through that, do your homeworks also. Now, as we have started year to year, and in this chapter, this is the revision chapter, and we know in year to year there are given different kinds of year and the year patterns and how to recognize or identify different kinds of animals. So in this regard, first we have differentiated and categorized the animals whose ears we can see and the animals whose ears we cannot see. And during this categorization and during this part of the chapter, we came to know what are the characteristics of the animals whose ears we can see, and what are the characters of those, or the appearance of those animals whose ears we cannot see. So within this regard, now I will just show you our picture of your book, page number 12. Refer to page number 12. There is one picture given. So this picture is given of different kinds of animal, and we will just identify different kinds of birds. Actually, in this page, they have given different kinds of birds picture. So can you identify this? This is, we can see, here is a crown, and the whole body is full with the feathers. We cannot see the ear of this animal. And what is it? It is a bird, or you can say it is a hen, not hen, it is a cock. Okay, so this comes in the category of bird. Now the very next, if we'll see, this is a sparrow. And here again, if we observe all the characters and all the things in this picture, we can see the whole body is covered with feathers, and we cannot see the hair, ears of this bird or this sparrow. And you can see this cock's hair or its feathers are quite different from this sparrow's feather. Their pattern, the not only the color, the pattern of the feather, and how they are situated, and how they are just making the pattern on its skin, it's totally different from the cock. Now next one is the parrot. This is a parrot, and we can see the color is different, the feathers are different, the shape and size of the feathers are also different, and they are making a total different pattern. Now the third one, this fourth one is actually a duck, and we can see its feather is totally white, or a single color feather, and these are also different. They are waterproof, so they are very shiny in the nature. And crow's feather, we have seen, all of us, we have seen the feather of the crows, and these are actually very different from the others of the other birds. And the last one, it is a frog. As we can see the webbed feet, and we can see the structure is a the structure of its face is just a triangular structure, and it is just started to leap, and the picture is showing its leaping position. So this is different from the other animals. These all belongs to bird category, but that one is amphibian category. And when we see and when we observe these all birds and animals very carefully, we will find that their hair, their body is actually full with feathers, but
in the case of amphibian, its skin is slimy and its skin is not covered with feather. But what is common among them? There is no external ear. If we will observe these all animals carefully, we can find, or we will find, that each and every animal having feathers except this frog. And the common thing is any of them do not possess external ears. So this is the common feature amongst the amphibian as well as the birds. So from here we can understand the animals who can fly, or the category of the birds as well as amphibians like the frog, some reptiles just like snakes, and you can say about that wall lizards, they also do not bear any kind of external ear. So what are the observations we are finding it over here? We are seeing the animals, just we will categorize. So what are the characters of those animals who are having the ears, and the animals who do not have any ears? So the birds whose whole body is covered with the feather and they do not possess any kind of external ear. In spite of the external ear, they have only two little holes, or you can see the holes on both sides of their head. As well as if we observe the frog, here also we can see that the frog's skin is very slimy and it is very coarse in nature, and its feet are actually webbed, but it has also no ears, or no external ears. Actually they have ears, but their ears are internal, and in spite of the external ear there are only two holes. So we came to know what are the characters of these kind of birds and animals who do not possess any kind of external ear. So what about the animals who are having the ears? So human beings are also animal. So we have our external ears. Everybody has external ears. Maybe the shapes are little bit different, but we all possess external ears. And the other mammals like dog is there, goat is there, elephants are there, lion, tiger, hippopotamus, these all animals. And what about the water animal? Who is the mammal in water animals? Whales are actually water animal, which belongs to mammal category or the mammal family. Okay, so these all animals possess hairs, or the small hairs on their body, or very maybe light hairs, and few of the animals having very thick hairs. So they all these category belongs to the animals who are having the hairs on their body, as well as they suckle milk to their baby, and they do not give birth to the they give birth to the baby, they do not lay eggs. And what about the birds and the reptiles and the amphibians? They lay eggs. So what is the difference? The animals who are having hairs on their body, not the feathers, hairs on their body, who suckles their baby, who give birth to their baby, and these all category possessing animals always having external ears. So we can see the examples of the animals, all kinds of mammals like elephant, lion, tiger, horses, cow, goat, etc. And what about the birds and the reptilians and the amphibians? They all possess feathers, or their maybe the coarse hairs on their body, or the feathers are having on their body. They take care of their baby, but they lay eggs, and after hatching, or after sometimes the babies comes out, but they do not give birth to the young ones. Okay, so these two are the differences, as well as birds never suckles milk to their baby, whereas the mammals and the animals who are having the external ears, they suckle their baby. So these all are the differences we are finding, the egg laying animals
and the animals who are giving birth to the young ones, and as well as you can say the animals who are having external ears and the animals who do not having or possess any external ears. So these all are the differences. Here some questions are given or framed here over here. Find out some other animals who have ear that we cannot see. Write their name. So it is your homework. You will write it down, the names of some other animals and the birds which are not given here. So there are so many, you can easily find those animals. Next, the example, an animal with ears like fan. Who is that animal? Yesterday we have discussed it. This is elephant. An animal with ears like the leaves. Which animal having the ears just like the leaves? They are buffaloes are there as well as deers are there. And the next is an animal with ears on the top of its head. Which animal is that? Who is having the ears on the top of its head? That is rabbit. Okay. Now an animal with ears on the both side of the head is also given here. You know very well that ears help us to hear. In some animals, we can see animal, and in some cases, we cannot see the animals. And animals ear, but those animals are also having the ear, but their ears are actually internal ears and they are hidden within their feathers. Okay, so that's all for today. Next, we will discuss discuss the question answers of the skin, related to skin. And we will again further we will have a look for the skin for the revision. Okay, so take care of your skin, take care of your own self, and stay at your home, be safe. Goodbye.